If you're going to spend money on new astronomy gear, you might as well save some money. I've been tracking the prices of a variety of items related to astronomy, and I did this during the last two Prime days and I had positive reception, so I thought I'd do it again. Just like last time, I'm tracking this on Google Sheets. The link to that is in the description below. The list is much larger than last time, so I won't go over any of the items. Instead, I'll show you how to read the spreadsheet yourself, how to filter it, and how to find what you're looking for. One thing to note before we get to the spreadsheet is that the Amazon and Agena Astro links are affiliate links. You don't have to use them, but I would highly appreciate it if you would. It costs you nothing, but it helps me out. So let's take a look at the spreadsheet. Before I get into the content of the spreadsheet itself, I want to show you how you can filter this yourself. So if you just hit this, you won't be able to do anything because it's view only. So what you need to do is you need to click on data. You do filter views and create a new temporary filter view. What this will do is it'll create a view for you where you can just go in and play with it. So for example, in the category, if I want to select just mounts, I can do that and click on mounts. And there we go. If you don't do a temporary filter view, you won't be able to do anything with it unless you make a copy of it. Now let's talk about the contents of the spreadsheet itself. We have three worksheets here. First is the All Astro stuff, which has a lot of generic items here, including cameras, camera lenses, eclipse glasses, mounts, power storage, and telescope accessories. We also have a telescope worksheet and a mini PCs worksheet, which I'll go over soon. The four main common stores I looked at are Amazon, Agena Astro, Astronomics, and High Point Scientific. You may notice that some items are listed multiple times, such as this ASI-523MC Pro, and that's because the prices differ. I want to show price differences between the different stores. Stores like Agena Astro and High Point Scientific share a similar pricing because they get their pricing from ZWO, and ZWO has a sale going on right now that brings their sale price way lower than Amazon. Up until then, Amazon was winning. And you may have also figured out that the column here has some conditional formatting so that if the price on Black Friday during the Black Friday sale is less than the price that I saw a week earlier, this was around November 14th and 15th, it turns green. Otherwise, it'll turn red. Then you know that it's not really worth getting. Or it may be still within your threshold, but something to think about. In the notes section, I try to provide other helpful information such as this one. This lens was $199 during one of the Prime days earlier this year, and it's currently $249. So it may not be worth it. You may want to wait for the next Prime day or another sale, or maybe no sale at all, and then the price will just go down by itself. A couple of items I'll point out that could make great gifts for astronomers in your life if you're not getting them yourself are the heated clothing here. I have a heated vest and heated socks, and I have to say that during cold nights, they are amazing. So I just left them here as examples. These aren't the ones that I own. I have a heated vest and heated socks and they were gifted to me, so I don't know where that listing is. So these are just examples. You don't have to use these. Go around, go in and click around and see what you can get. The other accessories you can get are like hand warmers. These are also, they can also make great gifts. And I did make a note here for little hotties is that if you have a Costco near you, Costco sells them for about half the price for the same 40. So if you want to get them at Amazon, it's $29, but at Costco, you could save another $14 or $15. And I also put some examples of storage devices here because if you shoot raw images or raw video, you know that they take up a lot of space. And there is a sale on these external hard drives. I did note that they're HDDs or hard disk drives and not SSDs, so they are going to be a little bit slower when it comes to transferring data, and they shouldn't be used to like run anything off of, just for storage, and that's totally fine. I'll probably end up getting the 8 TB one before the April 8th, 2024 eclipse. Going into the telescopes worksheet, this worksheet has a little bit more information. I also broke them down into telescope types, and I do know that Dobsonian reflectors and tabletop Dobbs are pretty much all reflectors, but I wanted to point out that they are different in terms of sizes, in terms of prices, etc. I have this one column here for beginner friendly. Anything with the wire, these are telescopes that I normally recommend someone who comes and asks me for advice. Depending on their budget and what they want to see in the sky, I'll talk to them and then I'll recommend some of these. Anything that doesn't have a wire, I'm not saying that they're not for beginners. Of course, beginners can buy them, but they're not things that I would recommend that somebody start the hobby with, especially like the NSCT, because those can get difficult. With that said, pricing for these telescopes haven't changed a lot. The best deal right now is this SkyWatcher EvoStar 100, which is a 100mm apochromatic refractor for $775, which is pretty amazing. And from the look of it, it comes with a diagonal, a couple of eyepieces, and this right angle corrected image finder. So I think this is a steal on Amazon. On Agena Astro, the same telescope is over $1,000. And I don't think it comes with, no, it does come with the same accessory. So That's fine. But yeah, you can see the price. And it's on sale here too. So this is probably not going to last. It's only 8 left. So at the time of this recording. And as the days passed, I'll check on these prices and update them accordingly. Now, looking at the last worksheet, mini PCs. This worksheet was my main motivator to make a list like this because I'm looking to get myself a mini PC to add to my astrophotography arsenal in 2024. I currently do all of my things on a Raspberry Pi, so of course that's listed here. I use Astroberry, I've been using it for a while, and it's amazing. But I wanted to also start using more of Nina. I currently use Nina on a laptop. I want to get something that is a little bit more reliable. And the prices for these haven't really changed much, but there are some. There's just this one good deal, but I have to look at the storage here. A couple of information that I listed here include the CPU, the speed, number of cores, GPU, RAM, and operating system. Because I wanted to make sure that these would run Nina or Sequence Generator Pro or Indian ECOS if I were to go that route. So I looked up their minimum requirements and these all fit. If you have any questions about any of the items I listed or didn't list, let me know in the comments below. I'll update the list and prices over the next week to see if we can spot any good deals. If a really nice deal pops up, I'll update the spreadsheet and also we'll make a community post. So if you aren't subscribed yet, subscribe so that you can get a notification when I update. I hope you have a very happy Thanksgiving if you celebrate, and I wish you all the best during this holiday season. Clear skies.